comfort pick. They're always looking for Trill to be landing these mana rifts, looking for a late game advantage, trying to secure the mana lead very early on.
Yeah, let's see if they can do it. Their stall-based tactics didn't work in the upper bracket as Kolo was able to 3-0 Method Orange earlier today, but now in the lower bracket, they have an opportunity at redemption. We do see the mana rift strategy already being employed by Trill. It's going to be a ticking clock for Metaphor's mana bar. Can the team of Storm counter-aggress before that clock runs out?
Yeah, we'll definitely have to see who Nesper's going to be going after in this matchup. Full blind secured onto Seedoo. He trinkets out immediately. Now any crowd control could be devastating for Method Orange. If they can find it, Metaphors with the Thorns forcing Trill back a little bit, but a grip into a double Chaos Nova. Nice setup here for Method Orange. Metaphors' mana is not doing well. He's already 60%. Trill's been doing a great job consistently landing those rifts so far, but Mets now could be in a little bit of trouble with the Infernals dropped as well. That's the Dark Soul used by Maldiva.
Yeah, Maldiva trying to counter-aggress. Huge hit on Mez. No trade just yet. Any magic shield, instant stabilization here for Method Orange. Surprisingly, though, no mana advantage as Trill is sitting far in the back in a mass entanglement likely, so nice talent decision there. Trill is not running reverse magic, so long as Metaphors drags Trill out of line of sight, he will be sitting extended crowd control with that mass entanglement talent choice. But with that ghoul running at Metaphors as well, it's unlikely that he will ever drop combat in order to drink and regenerate mana. So it's basically up to Maldiva and Nesper to kill Mez before Metaphors runs out of mana. Now that lead has established itself here early on as we get closer to dampening.
Yeah, when a Chaos Bolt lands on Mez, that gives him significant healing on his Death Strike, but now into a Kidney Shot, kind of loses that opportunity. Seedoo runs into the Smoke Bomb, drops the Earthen Shield Totem, and Mez should be able to survive, healing himself back up once again. Potentially, we'd like to see Nesper and Maldiva look for a swap onto Seedoo if they can. It doesn't seem like their pressure onto Mez so far has been significant, and Metaphors is slowly but surely running out of mana. Not exactly sure where the opening here is for Storm.
Good response by Seedoo during that smoke bomb, not overreacting and overcommitting his defensive lineup. Definitely not looking shooken up from their first series of the day here in game number one. Just playing it out methodically, putting Metaphors on that clock. Maldiva, though, managed to sneak in a fear on Seedoo, trying to develop more pressure off the back of it. Manages to pull anti-magic shield from Mez, but really no major defense forced on the side of Method Orange, and it's really Metaphors that is starting to falter with all three members of the team down to half health. Limited mana left in the tank. Nesper pulls away to try and assist by stunning up Trill, but Trill doesn't even care. He's immediately going back onto target, trying to gun down Metaphors. Metaphors needs to be careful. He stacks up on his team. It could be a triple stun and triple cleave, which with his current mana status is unlikely to recover. Constantly getting stun locked. At least Nesper and Maldiva have stabilized. We do see a blind play. Seedoo trinkets out. So maybe what I would like to see from Storm is a swap to Seedoo, try an all-in KO, because everything else is just slipping away.
Yeah, that's exactly what I want to see as well. And with Seedoo just basically automatically trading out his trinket for blind, there is an opportunity. But Mez with the Death Grip, he has a lot of interrupts for Maldiva as well as the anti-magic zone. They have the defense that they need. Method Orange, basically, they just need to play it out intelligently here. They have all the tools that they need to close out this game. A nice swap over onto Trill as Gladiator Safeguard does proc, keeping him alive. Blur is going to be activated as well as Trill looks to try to get back onto Metaphors. I'm not sure if Metaphors actually got any mana back. I don't believe he did, so still hovering around 25% mana. But if you look, Seedoo's actually falling behind as well. He's not going to have an opportunity to sneak away for a drink. And if Metaphors can hold on a little bit longer, I could definitely see them closing out this game.
Beautiful Cataclysm timing by Maldiva. It's going to get him a lot of Immolates for Soul Shards. He's falling behind, though. He needs to start counter-aggressing with that huge resource gain that he was able to secure. Double Mortal Coil, looking to build up for a huge Chaos Bolt, but there are multiple points to deny it. He's going to have to get through all those interrupts. He gets through one. He gets through the second. There's no third available. One Chaos Bolt sneaks through onto Seedoo as Nesper sets up a swap. Seedoo trades appropriately, but expends the remainder of his mana. Multiple pressure points here. Multiple defensive cooldowns forced as well, and suddenly Storm stay alive in this fight.
Yeah, Method Orange is falling apart. Seedoo into the Kidney Shot. Trill forced to trade out the Darkness. What is Seedoo going to do? He has the Spirit Link, the last line of defense. Gets into Ghost Wolf, going to be running and hiding behind the pillar. That Pack Spirit doing work to keep Seedoo alive, but now with no mana left, he might really struggle to keep Mez alive. Trill looking to get the last little bit of mana from Metaphors, who wasn't able to get a drink. Now activating Barkskin, Iron Bark, as well as the Thorns. So Metaphors with really no defense left, and Mez and Trill can connect onto Metaphors. They could surely take him down, but once once again, it looks like it's going to be Mez on Maldiva and Nesper and Trill still chasing down Metaphors. The split strategy from Method Orange seems to be working so far, but we've seen them really struggle to actually land a kill with the strategy.
I mean, both teams' compositions are weaker on the sides in terms of execution and finally putting someone down. They're great at stalling out. They're great for consistent pressure. But when it comes to actually killing somebody, both of these compositions, that's their major weakness, which is why we see these teams unable to just put that little bit of an oomph left in the game to take somebody down. Blind attempt here by Nesper, but it's the team of Storm on the back foot with all three members in danger. No mana left in the tank. Still multiple defense available for Method Orange as they are going to close this out shortly, I do believe. Maldiva doesn't have much. Metaphors tries to trade, but he still doesn't have anything really to work with, just hoping for Omen of Clarity regrowth, but not finding that opportunity, and Method Orange finally bank out victory. It was starting to not look so good, but they kept it together.
To have one win to work with in this series.
Yeah, if Storm can pull off this series, they may be able to overthrow Method Orange on the point standings, which would be huge. Obviously, Mew Mew Kitty Cats also battling to try and pass Storm themselves. So if you're Mew Mew Kitty Cats, you're rooting for Method Orange. You want them to just keep gaining points so that you can then pass Storm in the standings. Of course, they're not going to have control of that fate. It's entirely in the hands of the players in this series, but it's an elimination one, and it looks like Method Orange want to go after the healer Metaphors. Let's see how he handles it.
Yeah, Method Orange, they have to hold on tight. Claiming this series is so important for this team if they want to secure their third place spot right now or potentially move into second or first. Completely missing out on the first tournament, basically getting no points whatsoever. Every single one of these matches for Method Orange is increasingly important. Now Kidney Shot onto Trill. I think he should be fine, but he gets interrupted. Decent pressure here for Storm off the back of the Infernals and the Dark Soul, but once those cooldowns fade from Maldiva, that's going to be Sidu's opportunity to recover with his Ascendance, and I think now he should be fine. Still Trill going after Metaphors, looking to just burn him out of mana as soon as he can. Metaphors are already down to around 60%. He needs to start trying to do a better job of avoiding these, potentially running away, creating some distance, because if Trill can just play on top of the entire team, not only does he get the added benefit of consistently being on top of Metaphors to get the mana rest, but he also gets to help Mez out, get some cleave damage onto Maldiva and Nesper, which is going to tax Metaphors' mana even more.
So the main strategy for Team Storm, at least Metaphors and Maldiva, is to position so that Sidu has to move in and stand on top of his team. If they can position this way, then Nesper can have Fan of Knives hitting three targets and boost his damage. Smoke Bomb forces Sidu to make a decision. Does he run into the Smoke Bomb? Instead, Mez uses Icebound Fortitude to break out of it and run into line of sight. It's basically all up to Sidu to stay as far away from the fight as possible so that Nesper cannot benefit from this Flying Daggers build. And as long as Sidu can keep good positioning, then Trill's Mana Rifts should inevitably secure them victory.
Yep, Trill manages to find Metaphors. Metaphors with a nice route onto Trill. You can see Trill stuck very far away, and I think if Metaphors can consistently do that, that's another way for him to escape and preserve his mana. Decent pressure here onto Maldiva. Mez has been doing work in the meantime when Trill's been caught far away. And this is basically what we've seen so far. Mez and Sidu, they're against Maldiva and Nesper, whereas Metaphors and Trill are having their own little 1v1. And until Metaphors is out of mana, we don't normally see Trill come back and assist on damage. For now, he's going to be able to. Sidu moving forward, looking to stop any potential drink from Metaphors. If Metaphors can ever regenerate mana, we saw what a close call it was in the last game on the Grand Arena. Sidu was basically completely tapped on mana at the same time as Metaphors. So if we ever see Metaphors get away, regenerate mana, that could potentially be a lead for them. Big damage now onto Mez, as it looks like Storm is able to secure some pressure.
Gladiator Safeguard going to save Mez. Metaphors now under fire once again by Trill. Sidu moving forward as well with two members chasing him down. It's basically impossible for him to regenerate mana. Unfortunate fear pathing for Mez as he's feared across the entire map. No dispel for him. That does slow down the damage a bit for Metaphors to recover, which is fortunate times for Storm here in game number two as they try to tie it up. But I would say overall that it is not looking good for them. Sidu has a significant lead at this point. We're not even into dampening, and they were trying to take the small map advantage to boost Nesper's damage, but even that doesn't seem to be enough. I don't think this strategy is going to work for them. They're going to need a miracle.
At this point, they definitely will, and they almost had one on the Grand Arena when we saw them so far behind again on the Destruction Warlock with those two offensive cooldowns, both the Infernal and the Dark Soul. That's an opportunity for Maldiva to really boost his damage up and push through some of these defensives that Mez has available. AMS now not available for Mez, that anti-magic shell. Sorry, the AMS. Yeah, the anti-magic shell is not going to be available for Maldiva if he does use the Dark Soul. So potential opening there, but CD with every defensive, Method Orange is going to be feeling quite healthy.
Yep, Method Orange are in a solid position to get victory here on game number two. Just slow and steady wins the race. CD getting chaos bolted by Maldiva as they are getting a bit cheeky, maybe trying to open up some windows of opportunity to swap to him at some point. But Metaphors' clock is ticking. There's not much mana remaining. Maldiva tries to set up some damage, gets denied by Sidu. Trill still keeping up the chase. Nesper now getting pressured as well with two members low. This Innervate timing is critical. Metaphors getting free healing, gets denied now by Trill's Fell Eruption. That bonus free healing lost as Metaphors is on the run, but I'm not sure how much longer this kitty can run away from the fight. Double Capacitator Totem pinning down two members. Metaphors really starting to struggle.
Yeah, it definitely is. Mez in a kidney shot. Sidu trying to respond. Mez has to run out of that in that smoke bomb. He's not going to be able to receive any healing from Sidu. That does fade. Now Sidu finally has an opportunity to get some heals onto Mez. As Trill still in pursuit, caught into some fears. Metaphors actually might have regenerated some mana there. He did sit down for a little bit, got a little bit of his mana back, but really nothing significant. Trill still finding mana rips onto Metaphors consistently, and Trill has been on that Demon Hunter, one of the best Demon Hunters we've seen, to land those mana rifts, and it's been a strategy that Method Orange really has been focusing on more so than really any other team we've seen besides Method Black over in Europe, and it's really been a big part of their success so far in these cups.
All right, Trill just chasing down Metaphors. Mez building up momentum on two other targets so that Metaphors has to expend mana to heal three members and likely tap him completely out at that point. I'm looking for openings on the side of Storm. What can they get done? Now, I don't really see anything of significance. They have to still get through Sidu's Dire's Medallion. They'll blind to do that, but they need to survive. Even that is looking to be impossible at this point with Maldiva on 5% health, trying to turn it around with some Chaos Bolts, but not even finding that. Tremor Totem denies the fear. Maldiva gates to safety, but is it really that safe? Mez finally getting counter-pressured by Nesper, trying to put the team on his back, but Sidu denies that kill window with a Spirit Link Totem, connects a huge heal on that Ascendance, and Maldiva is likely to fall here in game two. There's just simply no mana left in the tank. Mind Freeze secures the kill. Method Orange advanced to match point.
And Method Orange just looking like they know exactly.
There's even a diminishing return on the disarm effect, so maybe they could use a grapple weapon and a dismantle then from Nesper and the potential Mistweaver that way. So we'll see what they end up going for. It looks like they're going for Mez.
Something needed to change. Let's see if this warrior can get it done.
See if the dice roll, triple sixes. Dismantle is selected for Nesper. Looking for a Death Knight counter comp strategy here from Storm. Even though it's very peculiar to see a pirate and an arms warrior battle together, this may be an answer to the Death Knight menace that Method Orange have brought to the composition. But Nesper on the back foot with Metaphors lockdown and crowd control, potentially closing this out in seconds. Storm are on match point. They've got an opportunity to overthrow Method Orange if they can win three games in a row, but this composition smells like desperation.
Yeah, and Mez with Chains of Ice is going to be super effective at kiting both Nespers and Sheepy Boy when he's not caught in crowd control. Nesper taking quite a bit of damage once again. Metaphors having to play catch up, but his mana's not looking well. The pressure from Method Orange is really high in this matchup. Sidu so far has been able to keep Mez nice and stable. I don't know if this comp's really working out for Storm. Metaphors falling further and further behind as he kites away, potentially looking for a drink. Pistol stun onto Sidu, as well as a grapple weapon onto Mez. Mez is going to be getting a little bit low, but all three members of Storm just falling apart here.
This looks terrible for Storm. There's no mana left already? Already? He can't even stay alive to Trill. There's no support at all in this composition. They were expecting to burst somebody down, but the defense can't be cracked. Method Orange should close this out securely. So much momentum in their favor. Blind attempt, they pull Sidu's trinket. If they don't swap to Sidu and kill him 100-0, there's no other opportunity. They're just all dead. Sheepy Boy gets stun locked. He's likely to fall. Sidu could purge if he really wants to. And Sheepy Boy falls. This desperate pull by Storm pulls nothing.
Storm wanted to
positionally
feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered in the middle of history the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.